Good morning, students. I hope you have done rational numbers, addition of rational numbers, and I have told you to do up to 7 number, 1 to 7 I have told you to complete. Have you completed? Or I do complete. Okay, if you have any problem, you ask me later on. So today we will do the subtraction of rational number. So subtraction of rational number, as we have done in addition, the closer property, associative property, commutative property. Similarly, in subtraction of rational number also, closer property is there. So closer property means what? Subtraction is closed. What does it mean? It means that if we subtract two rational numbers, if you take the difference of two rational numbers, the answer is also a rational number. That is called closer property. Alright. Next is your commutative property. Commutative property means what? Like we had done in addition, 3 plus 2 is equals 2 plus 3. That is commutative property. So if we take the subtraction in that way, it is not commutative. How? Because you see, so 3 plus 2, is it equals to 2 minus 3? 2 minus 3? 3 minus 2, is it equal to 2 minus 3? If I take 3 minus 2, is it equal to 2 minus 3? No. How? Because this is 1. Left side is 1, LHS is 1 and right side is minus 1. So, this is not equal. Similarly, if we take the fractions, the rational numbers also in that way, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 is not is equal to 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2. Because you see, if we do LHS and RHS separately, what is coming in LHS? 1 by 6 is coming. In RHS, what is coming? Minus 1 by 6. So, they are not equal. That means commutative property, subtraction is not commutative. Alright. Next is the associative property. Associative property is what we had seen in addition. That addition is associative. That means if we take two numbers, two rational numbers, alright, two later on together we take, suppose you take 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 5. 1 by 3 and 1 by 5 in bracket. And in the RHS, what I have taken, the first two in bracket and then the third one. So, you see, LHS, what are we are getting? 11 by 30. Alright, whereas in RHS, what are we are getting? Minus 1 by 3. That means, LHS is not is equal to RHS. That means what? Subtraction is not associative. So, these are the properties of rational numbers. Closure only, subtraction is closed. Commutative, no. Associative, no. Alright. So, this is all about the properties of subtraction. Next comes, up to 7 number we have done. So, from 8 number we will do today. So, see question number 8. What is given? Subtract 1 by 3 from 2 by 5. 1 by 3 from 2 by 5. What does it mean? If I say subtract 2. From 10, how will you do? We will do 10 minus 2. Yes or no? So, from whatever is given from, so that one will be in front. So, 1 by 3 from 2 by 5. That means what? 2 by 5 minus 1 by 3. So, what we get? 1 by 15. Alright, 1 by 15. So, like that, you will do question number 8. All the questions of question number 8 you will do. Alright. From whatever is given in from, that one will come in front. Clear? So, in that way, we will complete question number 8. Question number 9. Given what you see? You have opened your book, no? 1A, exercise 1A. Yes. So, next is your verify. So, verify is given what? You see, like first question is given what? 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 is not equal to 1 by 4 minus 1. How will you verify? So, what will you do? Separately, you find the value of LHS and RHS. That means first you find 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4. What comes? Then RHS you do 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3 you do. So first separately you find the value of LHS and RHS, and then you check whether LHS is equals RHS or LHS not is equals RHS. And then you will write verify. So wherever there is bracket, you see in the question number 39, question number 3 you see given in bracket, like 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 5. So 1 by 3 minus 1 by 5 in bracket. So wherever there is bracket, do the bracket work first. Alright, so you see 9 number first one is given what? It is given commutative property. We have seen commutative subtraction is not commutative. It will come. Alright, so 1 number and 2 number is given like it is commutative or not. So subtraction is not commutative. So it will be verified. And question number 3 and question number 4, what is given about associative property? Okay, so in bracket it is given. So first you will do the bracket work, that means 1 by 3 minus 1 by 5, 5. Alright, whatever you get, then from 1 by 2 you subtract, then another side. So we have seen also, when I told you about the property of subtraction, I said subtraction is not commutative. So here also it will come like that, LHS is not is equals RHS, so verified. In that way you will do 8 and 9 number. Alright, clear, no? Now, question number 10, you see, what is given in the question? The sum of two rational numbers is given what? Sum of two rational numbers is given minus 3 by 4. Alright. And one number is given how much? Minus 28 by 3. So what is the question? Find the other number. So we don't know about other number. So let other number is equals x. Alright, so as per question, what is given? Question is given that two rational number is given. So sum of two rational number, that means x plus sum, that is x plus minus 28 by 3 is equals given how much? Sum is given minus 3 by 4. Then you solve, find the value of x, you will get the answer. Clear? So, 10 A number I have done, you can see. So, B number is your homework. 10 B number, B 2 you will do. Clear? Next, 11 A number. See, what is given? What number should be added to minus 11 by 4? So, what number? So, we do not know, let the number. So, let the number be X. So, what number should be added? What number should be added to minus 11 by 4 to get minus 25 by 14. So you solve, find the value of x. Clear? So you will get the answer x is equals minus 27 by 28. Alright. So this is 11 A number I have done. So 11 B number you will do. And you see question number 12 A number. What is given? What number should be subtracted? So we do not know the number. So let the number be x. So, as per the question, what is given? What number should be subtracted? So, x should be subtracted from, so minus 7 by 8 in front, okay? Minus 7 by 8 minus x to get minus 5 by 12. So, we will solve, x is minus, alright? So, we will solve, we will get minus x is equals 11 by 24. Therefore, if we take this minus this side, because x should be positive, x we have to find the value. So, minus x value, the question is not asked about minus x. Question is about plus x. Okay, therefore x is equals, sign will come this and negative will come this. So, x is equals minus 11 by 24. That is the answer. Alright, next. So, with this 12 A number I have done. So, 12 B number is your homework. So, 10 bit B, 11 bit B. 12 bit B you will do by yourself. Clear? And 13 number is identify the true statements only. The sum of two rational number is rational number. Yes, that is the closure property we have done. So true. difference of two rational numbers is not or always rational number. That is false only, because difference is also rational number. We have seen, no, subtraction is closed, so the difference also should be rational. So that is false. Zero is not a rational number. That is false only. Zero is a rational number. All right, zero is a rational number. So zero is not a rational number. So that is false. All right, zero is a rational number. So that is false. Then question number 4. Addition is commutative on rational number. Yes, addition is commutative. We have seen the property of addition. Subtraction is commutative on rational number. No, just now we have seen subtraction is not commutative. So false. Addition is associative on rational number. Yes, we have seen addition is associative. If you remember, addition is associative. Subtraction is associative on rational number. No, subtraction is not associative. That is false only. Zero is the additive inverse of itself. Yes, we have seen the property is true. Zero is the additive identity for rational number. Yes, additive identity also I explained to you. So that is true. One is additive inverse of minus one. Yes, that is true. Because all the numbers additive inverse it is. If the number is positive, the additive inverse is negative. So if one is one side, so its additive inverse will be minus one. So that is also true. So with this, I completed exercise 1A. You do the homework, whatever I said. So tomorrow we will do 1B. Thank you.